Edgar Lungu is arriving. The stadium is really excited.
Wonderful.
It's a moment that they have been looking forward to.
In a very peaceful way.
What's going to follow thereafter, which would be the inauguration.
Now, Vuyo, as of course we can see through the visuals on our screens right now, with of course the president-elect Edgar Lungu arriving right now, I can see so much media frenzy occurring around him. We see security around him. What are the people of Zambia saying? Are they happy with the newly elected president?
They are very happy. If the scenes we saw last night are anything to go by, he is someone indeed very popular. Oh, of course, some were saying it is because of the party he belongs to, the Patriotic Front, and because of the man he is now going to succeed, which is President Michael Sata, who died late in October. So he
that is our president,
a
our
beneficiary
president
of what Michael Sata did for this country in a very short time. But just to take you back to last night, as soon as the Deputy Chief Zambian Electoral Commission announced, made that all-important declaration, young people stormed the National Results
Let's
Center.
Listen to his federal song as opposed to take and, his sins at the swearing in.
The police were confused.
Pick it up right now, musicians.
They fired tear gas. I can't remember when was the last time. It was in the
80s
when I had this, that smell and that taste of tear gas. And last night, our crew had it. But it was all because of the confusion, because the youngsters were quite excited. They were very happy that this man was going to be had now been elected the president of this country. And thereafter they stayed on. They were on the streets. They were singing. It was all jubilation. After that, we came here, right where we are, at the stadium to ring for this morning again. It was amazing. Thousands and thousands of people who were here, young people who were here at the stadium, singing, dancing. We left after 2 this morning and they were still here. Tumi?
Now, let's move on to today. What can we expect to see unfolding at the National Heroes Stadium this morning? We've seen some of the dignitaries who are seated, like Zimbabwean President Robert Mugabe, you know, as well as former President Dr. Kenneth Kaunda. But what can we see unfolding today at the Heroes Stadium?
Thank you. Clear, please. Can you clear?
Well, of course, I mean, the main item on the agenda is the official, is the inauguration of Edgar Lungu as the 6th president of Zambia. Of course, there will be speeches.
He
will be speaking. We are also expecting the chairperson of SADC, Zimbabwe's president, Robert Mugabe, to also have a few words. Well, he's not a man of a few words, but he is expected to speak as well.
Right,
perhaps
so
Mr. Guy Scott to do a bit of a handover as well. Those are really the main items on the agenda. Everything else will be just part of the entertainment that will be part of the ceremony, the singing and the dancing and all that.
Preside over the inauguration ceremony for the president-elect. May I now request Kenyon, Reverend Henry McPhail, Head of Chaplaincy, Zambia National Service, to give us an opening prayer. Reverend McPhail. Let us pray. Tears may linger for a night, but rejoicing comes in the morning. Rejoice, Zambia, for the glory of the Lord is risen with healing in his wings. Thank you, Father, you have been our shelter from age to age. Leaders come from you, and as the president for this great Republic of Zambia is being sworn into office, we rejoice as a nation because you have raised us from ashes. You have turned our mourning into joy. Glory be to you, Most High God. Arise, O God, and let your enemies be scattered. We receive your servant, the President-elect, Mr. Edeka Changwa Lungu, whom you have appointed at such a time as this one. Our President, our Jubilee President, let him rule without segregation. Let him rule firmly, but with a kind heart. Let him embrace diversity and difference of opinions. And as a father to the nation, provide leadership. We pray for the foreign heads of state and foreign government representatives present here. We pray that you may bless them and thank you for allowing them passage into our country, even as we pray for your spirit upon them. We thank you for their presence at this auspicious occasion. Bless this occasion as we gather here. Cover us with your presence and anoint your servant for the task you have raised him for. Let your favor and protection cover your servant as he takes office. Bless us all as we embrace your servant to govern us. We make our prayer through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Kenno Matveo. It is now my singular honor to introduce the Secretary to the Cabinet, Dr. Roland Mususka, who will now preside over the inaugural ceremony. Dr. Roland Mususka, sir. We may be seated. Thank you so much.
Your Excellency, Dr. Guy L. Scott, MP, Acting President of the Republic of Zambia, and Dr. Sharon Scott. Your Excellency, Mr. Edgar Chaba Lungu, President-elect of the Republic of Zambia, and Madam Esther Lungu. Your Excellency, Mr. Robert Gabriel Mugabe, Chairman of the Southern Africa Development Community, SADC, and President of the Republic of Zimbabwe, and Madam Grace Mugabe. The Right Honourable Dr. Barnabas Mufuso, Prime Minister of the Kingdom of Swaziland. Your Excellency, Mr. Mzengo Kaenza, Peter Pinda, Prime Minister of the United Republic of Tanzania. Your Excellency, Dr. Kenneth David Kaunda, First President of the Republic of Zambia. Your Excellency, Mr. Rufia Bezalibanda, Fourth President of the Republic of Zambia, and Madam Tanzania Banda. Mr. Davis Chama, General Secretary General of Patriotic Front. Your Excellency, Dr. George Develo Pinto Chikoti, Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Angola. Honorable Dr. George Chaponda, Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Relations of the Republic of Malawi. Engineer Michael Kamau, Cabinet Secretary of the Minister of Transport of the Republic of Kenya. Your Excellency, Mr. Thomas Waka, Vice Prime Minister of Transport of the Democratic Republic of Congo. Dr. Sarah Fairwa, Under Secretary of State, United States of America. Your Excellency, Madam Justice Lombe Pinch Besakunda, Acting Chief Justice. The Honorable Justice, Dr. Patrick Matibini, Speaker of the National Assembly, members of the Central Committee of the Patriotic Front, Honorable Cabinet Ministers and Deputy Ministers here present, the Executive Secretary Sadi, the Executive Secretary Komesa, Your Worship Engineer Mlengasata, Mayor of the City of Lusaka, political party leaders, Your Excellencies, Ambassadors and High Commissioners accredited to Zambia, senior government officials, former leaders in the Government of the Republic of Zambia, religious and civic leaders, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great pleasure to welcome you at this inauguration ceremony for the sixth President of the Republic of Zambia at our National Hero Stadium. I would like to thank you all on behalf of the Government of the Republic of Zambia. During this ceremony, we witness the inauguration of Mr. Edgar Chaba Lungu as the sixth president of our great country. This indeed is, as the psalmist put it, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we as Zambians should rejoice and be glad in it. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, today marks a new dawn in the history of the Republic of Zambia, when the sixth president will be inaugurated in the Jubilee year after Zambia clocked 50 years of independence on 24th October 2014. This ceremony sadly follows the demise of our fifth president, Mr. Michael Chufya Sata, who passed away on 28th October 2014 and was put to rest on 11th November 2014. May his soul rest in peace. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, after serious campaigns by various political contenders, the people of Zambia, with the help of God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, have spoken through the exercise of their right, the right to elect the leader. It is appropriate for us to extend our heartfelt congratulations to the President-elect on this victory. As we begin the proceedings of this ceremony, it is my hope that you enjoy the ceremony, and I wish our distinguished heads of state and government and other foreign dignitaries a present stay in the city of Lusaka. I thank you. Now it is my privilege to call upon the Honorable Lady Justice, Mr. P. Shibesakunda, to come forward and start to take position to swear in the President-elect. My lady.
That he has taken over. What we are about to see, what you see happening now, is the handover of symbols of the office of the president, which are going to be the Republican Constitution, the Zambian flag, and the presidential standard. Those will be handed over very shortly. to the president. There they are. Those are the instruments of power. There's a transfer now of power from the acting president to the president now, the 60th president. The Republican Constitution, the Zambian flag, the presidential standard. Maka, maka, ya kwela, maka, ya kwela, maka. Kwinangu ya sila, kwinangu ya yamba. That is transfer of power. It is done. It's a done deal. Round of applause. We have a president of the Republic of Zambia, Mr. Edgar Chagwa Lungu. Just a minute, we are going to see His Excellency moving to the saluting task to get his first presidential salute. May I request that we all be upstanding? Thank you. Shall we stand? Now is Commander-in-Chief of the Zambia Armed Forces. Okay, silence, 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 silence. What we see. For the president to inspect the guard of honor mounted by the 2nd Battalion Zambia Army. It is a wonderful thing. Abakuluma nchitonomba, bayambo kulumba. All the pressmen, move away from the parade. Provost, do your work. Thank you. Nobody goes at the parades there. Provost, police. That is the Commander-in-Chief inspecting the Guard of Honor as his first assignment. Manja, 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 iwe. Those who can not see, just watch from the screen. It's wonderful, on the screen there, our president inspecting the Guard of Honor, mounted by the 2nd Battalion of the Zambia Army.
Are they gonna come back to you?
Well, that was the newly elected and now inaugurated
Excellency, permission to carry on, Your Excellency,
President of the Republic of Zambia.
A round of applause. The president has just given permission to the parade commander. Could I request the provost that as His Excellency is taking his salutes now, I would request that everybody clear from here. The soldiers are going to march. Clear away from here. Come behind me, all of you. Provost, can we do our job? This is a military parade, and we don't joke. Move away, everybody out behind me. Everybody out.
Here. I am a guy. Oh,
Very shortly, we are going to see a march pass by all services. Zambia Army, Air Force, Zambia Police Service, Zambia National Service, and a flight pass. Mamba is just getting permission from His Excellency the President. Listen in. We are now going to see the march pass by Zambia Army, Zambia Air Force, Zambia Police Service, Zambia National Service, and the fly pass from Zambia Air Force. I want all of you to clear so that there's no obstruction when the marching is taking place. Or otherwise, I'll look you up. Excellent. Manja, 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 wonderful. Wonderful. This is a wonderful parade for the president. They'll be closing in to come and pass through for a presidential salute. Manja, 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 you were. Thank you.
it's the police.
Wonderful Manjari Mwe. We see the parade moving. Zambia Army, Zambia Air Force, Zambia Police Service, Zambia National Service, and there will be a fly pass very shortly. That is Zambia Air Force in action. That is a big formation, the sign of victory. Guata. That is Zambia Air Force, followed by Zambia Police Service. Followed by Zambia National Service as a last guard.
Rapol, Tabo has come, so do speak to him.
In front of the heads of state and government, can you please clear, including those of you that are here? By my order and command, clear right now. Clear from here. Provost, can you help me? Police, can we do our job? His Excellency is taking his seat back on the swearing-in dais. As the President moves to the saluting of the swearing-in dais, may I prepare Defence and Security Choir for a song as you clear from there. Defence and Security Choir. Just wait for the parade commander to finish. Hold on, Defence and Security Choir. Man, Jai Wes, one of the many pitch tickets of parade up by. Thank you, well done. Defence and Security Choir.
Excuse me. Forever. anywhere.
Your Excellencies, Heads of State and Government, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is now my singular honor and privilege to invite His Excellency Mr. Edgar Chagwa Lungu, President of the Republic of Zambia, to address the nation. May I invite His Excellency to make his inaugural address. Your Excellency, sir.
Republic of Zambia, Dr. Kenneth David Kaunda. Your Excellency, the fourth President of the Republic of Zambia, His Excellency Mr. Rupia Boitali Banda and Mrs. Tandiwe Banda, whom I presume should be here. Attorney General of the Republic of France, Mr. Davis Chama, members of the Central Committee of the Patriotic Front, the immediate past First Lady, Dr. Christine Kaseva Sata, Honorable Cabinet Ministers, Deputy Ministers, and Members of Parliament, Secretary of the Cabinet, Dr. Musiska, Your Lordships, Justices of the Supreme, Your Lordships and Lordships, Justices of the Supreme and High Courts of Zambia, Your Worship, the Mayor of the City of Lusaka, Engineer Mlenga Sata, and other civic leaders, leaders of all political parties present here, Your Excellencies, Special Representatives of Heads of State and Government, Cabinet Secretaries and Senior Government Officials, Service Chiefs, Your Royal Highnesses, Your Excellencies, Ambassadors, and High Commissioners accredited to the Republic of the Republic of Zambia, may I simply say, all protocols observed. Countrymen and women, 58 years ago, I was born. Edgar Chagwa Lungu at Mola Central Hospital on the Cockerville. And I grew up in Kidwe, Chimene Township. And later, of course, I moved on to Lusaka and settled in the capital city, as you may be very well aware. As I stand before you today, as the sixth president of the great Republic of Zambia, I am overwhelmed with gratitude. And I feel greatly humbled that you have decided to make me your servant. You are my masters. I am your number one servant. My primary and inescapable duty is to enjoin you, my fellow countrymen and women, in all corners of our large country, expressing our unqualified and very profound gratitude to God Almighty for preserving and guiding us in the very trying 3 months since the tragic and timely death of our beloved President, His Excellency Mr. Michael Chilufya Sata. May his soul rest in peace. At this point, may I simply call upon all of us to be upstanding for 1 minute to commemorate and remember our departed leader.
Shall we be upstanding? We observe a minute of silence. Imini nenwonse. A minute of silence. The Kenichongo. Today we shall take our children. Thank you.
Wechili wechakale kabisa mewuri we ukuno pala meji ya suwi nemuri we wechili wechakale kabisa. Fellow countrymen and women,
we may be seated, thank you.
Sit down, thank you. Fellow countrymen and women, comrades, it has not been an easy time. Only our unique collective wisdom and the spirit of human fellowship, so firmly embedded in our national character, has sustained us this far. This extraordinary fellowship forms our national cohesion. Countrymen and women, the process leading to the election, especially for us in the ruling Patriotic Front, was not easy. It was fraught with difficulties, but ultimately the good Lord guided us, and my nomination as the presidential candidate for our party was validated ultimately. There is no room, let alone time, for rancor or settling of scores of any kind at all. On the other hand, I want to tender my gratitude to all my colleagues in our great party, the Patriotic Front, for their unanimous decision to elect me as president of the party, which ultimately qualified me as presidential candidate. The journey was sometimes acrimonious and fractious as we tried to find common ground as a family, and also as we from time to time fought political battles with the opposition. We traversed the country, we went to the election, and we won simply because we focused more on that which unites us as opposed to that which divides us. I must say that the just ended election clearly shows that there is still work to be done on the national building front. Some colleagues in the campaigns stooped so low as to appeal to tribalism and regionalism. Name calling and violence among many other vices. Such politicking runs counter to the fundamental principle of upholding human dignity on which Zambia was founded. The principle of one Zambia, one nation cannot be sacrificed for political expediency, especially that which is driven by tribalism. We must never forget that the freedom we enjoy in Zambia today was achieved at a great sacrifice by our founding fathers. And those pandering to tribalism and dividing our people are working against the great sacrifices our forefathers made. we must remain true to the vision of our founding fathers. The United Zambia, proud and free, a people that will appreciate one another on the basis of character and not tribe, because this cage is a real threat to national cohesion. We must always realize that at the end of the day, we are one great family, one people, created in the image of God Almighty. We now, countrymen, must move forward as a united and healed nation, a healed political party, a united nation, a united people. Whenever elections are held and are over, we Zambians have in the past demonstrated that Zambia is bigger than any single individual, including me. To this effect, I want to take this opportunity to congratulate the 10 other contenders who ran for the presidency, especially one Hakainde Hichilema, who mounted a formidable campaign countrywide. The free atmosphere under which the election was conducted is a clear testimony of a mature democracy. The kind of competition we saw nurtures our democracy. This was made possible, I must boast, because of the PF government's guarantee to the constitutional guarantees, namely free speech, freedom of association, freedom of assembly, amongst many other civil and political liberties we have in the constitution. We cannot be guaranteed by the political party in our power. PF has enabled democracy to survive the challenges that the nation faces. I must congratulate the party for that. The other PF members will clap for themselves here. I wish to recognize the valuable endorsement we got as a Patriotic Front from President Rupia Kwezani Banda, the MMD members of Parliament, and the MMD members across the country, and all the voters from other political parties and non-members of political parties who supported my candidature. To you all, I say, may God Almighty, this will bless you for making those selfless decisions that will assist to foster unity and development in our country. To all the citizens in general, I wish to express my gratitude with due humility for the trust reposed in me by electing me the 60th president of our great nation. You have indeed placed on my shoulders a very heavy responsibility to be ever mindful that I have no leeway for lapses which may induce Zambians into thinking that they misplaced their confidence and trust by voting for me. As I have stated, we were 11 candidates for the presidency, and each and every one of us had profound messages to the voters and the country as a whole, but you chose me. For this, I'm greatly humbled. The bottom line is that we all want our country to move forward and to banish squalor and poverty in our midst. Only one of us could end up as president and have that singular honor and privilege. I'm humbled eternally and indebted to you all, my fellow citizens. Countrymen and women, I promise that I will serve with diligence and deep sense of duty and commitment, and I will not hesitate to submit myself to your guidance and collective wisdom. In this election, there are no victors nor vanquished in the process. We are all winners, and I have an equal duty to foster harmony and togetherness. It's the only way to accelerate the development of our country. I promise to work towards making political process in our country free and open. Candidates and women, the fabulous wealth living side by side with abject poverty in our country is a moral outrage and a slur on our collective conscience. It hurts me. It's unacceptable, and we must all join the crusade against poverty. Not through some of those dazzling rhetorics I hear, but through working hard. We must balance our privileges and rights with duty, responsibility, and obligation to our country. I'm fully aware of the depth of poverty that continue to afflict the great majority of our people. It unsettles me to see families go hungry when ours is a wealthy nation. I am aware of the many mothers that walk long distances in order to give birth, to collect water, to take children to school, and so on in their daily life. I'm aware of the many young people who still cannot access a decent education, the many youths without jobs because the economy is not big enough to absorb them. I'm aware of farmers who experience delayed payment for their crop. I'm aware of a few people who are getting stupendously rich illegally, while the majority teeter on the brink of poverty. This saddens me. Something countrymen must be done in our generation, in our time, must be done now. Countrymen, I know I'm stepping in the shoes of a giant, of a man. A man who was our torchbearer and a symbol of our party's vision of a robust transformative development agenda, which in the last 3 years has moved our country forward and created a momentum which we must accelerate and sustain at the same time. President Sata's legacy will forever be our beacon of inspiration. Like late President Sata, I come from a humble background, and I have experienced the agony and anguish of deprivation. Therefore, when I say I'll be reliable in uniting the country in our war against inequality, social injustice, and deprivation, do not take this for a joke. I become president at a time when the outlook for the global economy is gloomy. Lately, the World Bank has upgraded the global GDP growth from 3.5% to 3%. Therefore, my perception of the downward trend is accurate or correct or well-founded. We are all aware in our country of the significant decline in the commodity prices, including our major commodity cover. There will therefore be need not only for belt tightening, but for radical rethinking of the way we do things. It cannot be business as usual. We have to tighten our belts a bit. However, we shall continue building all the social, economic, infrastructure projects planned under the leadership of our late president. All the projects and programs shall be executed as planned, and where possible, as I've said earlier on, even accelerated. The overarching aims of our socio-economic diversification, poverty reduction, and promotion of meaningful participation of Zambians in the economy as entrepreneurs and workers shall be enhanced. We expect our socio-economic policies to accelerate Zambia's march to a middle-income country on a sustainable basis by the year 2030. Countrymen and women, let me continue promising that we will be a listening government. Our doors will always remain wide open to workers, farmers, entrepreneurs, small, medium and large businesses who keep our economy running. This includes the man on the street who completes the value chain and the consumer. To all you, I and my colleagues in government will listen.
Thank you.
Our country will continue to maintain and even improve on a conducive environment for investors, both local and external. Our policies will be underpinned by consistency and predictability. Recently, we have restructured the revenue system for the mining industry from a corporate profit-based tax to a mineral royalty one, which is simple and the final tax. Government's desire to ensure companies pay the right taxes will continue. I must emphasize this because some people don't understand. Government's desire to ensure companies pay the right taxes will continue. This is an imperative of good tenets of governance, and let me assure investors that we remain open to dialogue so that government continues to provide the desired conducive environment for private sector growth, but at the same time provide for the people of Zambia. Country law agreement. As your president, I want to focus on doubling the number of defense personnel houses and other essential workers. This is an ongoing exercise, and I want to complete the massive road expansion program which Mr. President Michael Kifeza has left. I also want to complete the construction of the 650 health posts, among the many other development programs currently going on in our country. I want to hand you a new constitution. We will definitely deliver a people-driven constitution as per the roadmap recently released. In this respect, I'm hereby appointing one renowned and respected lawyer, Dr. Simbia Kula, to immediately become Minister of Justice and see that this is done. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a momentous day. On this day, I only would like to thank you Zambians for what you are. I'd like to thank you for being a peaceful, loving people. You have re-energized me and reaffirmed the peace spirit that was in the past overcome with desire to continue Mr. Sata's vision. This is a spirit that has lifted Zambia from the brink of political instability. My administration shall continue with the transformation of our country. To realize the dream, we must remain a beacon of peace and hope. We ought to stick to the rule of law and good governance. To our friends in the region, Africa and beyond, we warmly extend a hand of friendship, brotherhood and solidarity. Zambia shall continue to pursue progressive policies of peaceful coexistence, non-interference in the affairs of other states, and mutual respect for one another. Fellow countrymen, at this point in time, I would like to thank one person, a reliable ally and partner, my wife Esther. for the unflinching support and wise counsel. She and my family, she and my other family members have endured the loneliness of the absence of a father and a husband during my long time away from home as we were busy campaigning. To my wife for more than 30 years, Esther, you're a true friend and a true comrade. I want to thank my grandson Kishoma, among so many other grandsons and daughters that I have, and all my in-laws. I'm glad to have all of you on my side. I thank you. I render my deep thanks to my wider family, friends, and colleagues in the Patriotic Front. And indeed to my many other friends and every other Zambian who supported and encouraged me in one way or the other. And those who criticized me because out of criticism I became better. I want to thank my great team, the members of the Central Committee, members of Parliament, cabinet ministers, and indeed others who volunteered to work with us. The national team, the national campaign team, which later incorporated President Biya Mbanda's team, to you, I say thank you. All the local campaign teams across the country, I say thank you. Our great Patriotic Front cadres who keep this party going, I say thank you. Your support has been invaluable from the start, and I will need you even more in the days to come. To those opposition leaders who may have conceded defeat, I thank you for acknowledging this basic character of democracy. To those who are dissatisfied, good luck, we have also gone there. Local and foreign business and interests, let me assure you that your investment is safe and shall continue remaining safe on my watch. We shall try as much as possible to balance your interests against those of our people. In conclusion, let me say on this subject that COPPA is important to us as the main foreign currency earner. But I want to step up the rate of economic diversification and explore other ways of earning more income from other activities such as agriculture, tourism, manufacturing and so on. To our partners in the economy, let me assure you that we seek nothing but a win-win situation. To all of you gathered here, all of you food soldiers from Patriotic Front who contributed in big and small way, you make me proud. However, I would like to stop here and get back to work because there is no honeymoon for us. And as your new president and commander-in-chief, let me assure you that this is not deliberate, but this is the way Mr. Saga would have loved to see us continue with his legacy. This is just a curtain raiser. We have work to do. Tomorrow, I will be swearing in a few more ministers whom I will be appointing in the course of the day. Please.
let me say, I will go home full of melancholy. Remembering this day, because you, Zambians, voted for a Jubilee president. And as your Jubilee president, I will target at reducing your poverty, and not my poverty. I will grow jobs to give you hope. Because I share the same background as you. To the people of Zambia, for your kind thoughts and consideration, that I can preside over your fate and destiny, I say it my life. Certainly, I will need to end the prayers, for even then, only God is our final guide and habitat. I loved it when I read the newspaper today. The acting president was saying it was more than the way that it was over. It was more than the way that it was over. It was more than the way. Let's allow God to continue working in our land. Let me say, I recall when I was a young lawyer appearing in court before the late Judge Stengel, may so rest in peace. I say, finally, my Lord, finally. How many finalies are you going to give? Just go on. I hope this finally I'm giving is the final of my name. As I conclude, let me state that politics is not just about winning and celebrating the victory. It's about meeting the needs and aspirations of the people. In this contest, I want to call upon all those who participated in the politics of electing a new president for Zambia and lost to come on board and join us in saving our beloved Zambian people. Let me remind my colleagues in government. Let me remind my colleagues in government, those to be appointed, and the ruling party, that the period before the election is very short. We must therefore work very hard in the remaining 18 months to retain the confidence of our master, the Zambian people. Our work starts today. God has brought us to Zambia, and we pledge to honor him by adhering to Christian values. Zambia shall remain a Christian nation, runs to other religions. I must make this very clear. Zambia shall remain a Christian nation, but with runs to other religions. May God bless the Republic of Zambia. Let us always hold each other's hand and reach out. Let love be at the core of our activities. God bless you all. God bless Zambia. Before I thank you, let me underscore that tomorrow morning at 9 hours, there will be swearing in for new cabinet ministers. Some will be reappointed, others by God. Thank you very much.
Banja, banja, banja. Banja! Thank you, Excellency. At this particular moment in time, may I request His Excellency the President to release the dogs and thereafter cut the balloons, Your Excellency.
Well, newly elected President of Zambia, Edgar Lungu, giving quite a comprehensive speech which had everything for everyone,
and unity
from the workers, for the workers. He had promises, the promises that he made around their salaries, promising
there we
a
are.
New constitution.
There we are.
Someone everyone has been looking forward
there
to.
There we are, the door of the